Hello everybody on YouTube, this is Super Nintendo, and welcome back to another episode of The Legend of Zelda Ocarina of Time. In the last episode, we managed to get ourselves our key to getting into the first temple. We also got ourselves a horse by the name of Epona. We also managed to get ourselves a couple of heart pieces and another gold skulltula, rounding up our current number to being 45, and getting all of the gold skulltulas in Kakariko Village. In this episode, well, since we're here in the Lake Hylia, there's a couple of things I want to do here before we do anything else. So, generally speaking, when there is this area that Navi will go over to with a green thingy-do. Die! Stupid Gwei. You can play the Scarecrow song. And Pierre will appear. You can then hookshot onto him, and it's actually pretty cool. Pierre will be very helpful to getting us some collectibles, but for now, here, we got a piece of heart. Whee! Ow. I was kind of hoping we would land on the plant. But since we have this plant, we can now come over here. Although I think, yeah, there is, I think, a scarecrow hookshot thing over there. But, you know, let's go fishing. Hey, mister, I remember you. Been a long time. How many years has it been? 7 years? What have you been doing all that time? Just sleeping, mostly. You're my only customer. I'm almost out of business. Seriously, on top of that, my hair. Never mind. Well, do you want to go fishing? It costs only 20 rupees. Oh no, your rumble feature isn't on, blah 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 blah. It's basically the same advice he gave us last time. And just like last time, we want to catch the fish in that location that we caught last time. Only now, the fish is bigger and stronger than it was before. So it'll probably be a little bit harder. Bite the hook. Bite the hook, you big fat bastard. I know you ate a baby! Damn it! I swear, it usually doesn't take this long. There it goes. What the? I did do that! What the fuck? Screw you, game! I swear to God, if that big fish went into the middle again, I'm gonna fucking scream. No, he didn't. Hooray! You get to keep your eardrums another day, viewers. What? I did set the hook! What the fuck? You heard me! You heard me click the fucking stick down! This fish is officially on my shit list. Come on. Are you? What the fuck? This is the third goddamn time this has happened. I swear my game is sentient and is just doing this to piss me off. I've been here for 15 goddamn minutes. God knows if that's actually the truth, because the stopwatch on the app I record my commentary with is not exactly accurate. It's off by quite a bit a lot of the time. Bite my hook. Let me turn you into fish sticks. And then people will laugh because I stick... Because I like fish sticks. And I stick them in my mouth. And that makes me a gay fish. I don't care. Fourth time this has fucking happened. What the fuck? Why is it doing this? You can hear me. I'm clicking the thing down when I do that. And I'm pressing the A button. Why is it not setting? What the fuck? Bite the fucking hook. You know what? I'm gonna use the song of the sun song to turn it to a new day. Maybe that will fix my chances. Cause if not, I'm gonna get in there, take my sword, and shove it down that fish's ass. This is legitimately frustrating now, because I've done this before on my first try without too much of an issue, and it does this. It's like fucking random how it does this, and it's really irritating. Like, I really hate the behavior of the fish, how it's completely fucking random. And I think I'll turn it to nighttime, because I hear... rumors that people say it's like they bite more often at nighttime. So we're gonna go night fishing. Is my hook not good enough for you? Huh? Is it not good enough for you? Is that why you do these things? Huh? Is my hook not good enough for ye? For ye? Oh, you judgmental douchebag. You only want the highest quality hooks, don't you? Probably ones with worms. Huh? Huh? Ah, bah, bah. Come on. Bite the damn hook. Oh, you judgmental douchebag. I will have your giblets. And I will have them for dinner. I like seafood. Yes, finally. Got you hooked. Come on. Come on. You're so close. You're so close. Come on. Come on. Come on. Yeah, got ya, you son of a bitch. Yeah, this is a real lunker. It weighs 18 pounds. I want to keep it, thank you. Finally gotcha, you son of a bitch. I don't know why that guy was so hard to catch this time. It's just, What do you want? I want you to weigh my fish. Whoa! This fish is huge! It looks like a new record. It weighs at least 18 pounds. Seriously, okay, here's your prize. We get the golden scale. With this, we can now dive much deeper than we could before. So, there is something else here that we could catch, but I don't really see any reason to do it. There's something in this in this fishing hole called the Hylian Loach. It's apparently very notorious to catch, very difficult, but it's just for bragging rights. You could do it if you really enjoy this mode that much. I'm not gonna do it because I'm not that masochistic. I don't really know how to get the Hylian Loach. And to be honest with you, I really don't care. You don't get anything for it as far as I know. However, there is something kind of cool that you can do. What is this? There is something kind of cool where you can apparently use the fishing hook and get this guy's hat. I don't really know how to do it, but here is some footage of this happening. Now that we have this done after goddamn 26 minutes, there is something I want to do at the Lakeside Laboratory. Real quick. Laboratory. In Dexter's laboratory lives the smartest boy you've ever seen. But Didi blows his experiments to smithereens. That is the loom that doom while things go boom in Dexter's lab.
You may not have noticed, but I've been watching you. You touched the bottom just now. Fantastic. I'll give this to you.
We get another piece of heart for collecting that. Very nice. Okay. Now that we are done here, for the time being, I will start a new recording, and then we will head over to the Kokiri Forest and actually try to get on with some story shit. Sorry, that was not supposed to take as long as it did. Okay, enough distractions. Let's go to Kokiri Forest. Kokiri Wood. Kokiri something. Kokiri Bake Off. Let's go to the Kokiri Bake Off. Even though we still have no idea why we grew up, I wonder if the Kokiri are also older. Something to ponder. Curiosa and Curiosa. Sorry, Epona, you can't go in. Ring Glide boys only. Whoa. There's giant Deku Babas. Big Deku Baba. Hit it when it lunges at you. It will stand upright, cut it quickly to get a Deku stick. Hi there. So, the big Deku Babas, they're pretty much the exact same as the normal ones, just bigger. And there's also a couple of Mad Scrubs here. Very, very odd that they've set up camp here, though. What happened in the 7 years since we've been gone?
Since we've been gone! I have killed you for the first time.
And there's Octoroks here. And more big Deku Babas. Skulltulas, which our new fangled hookshot can pierce right through. Ooh, bombs can kill these things in one hit. That is really good to know. I never actually bothered to try that. The Great Deku Tree is still dead, unfortunately. And I guess somebody propped up its mouth, because now we can't get in there. Not that we really have a reason to go in there. I wonder if... Yeah, we can't go in there. Die, Meta Humpa. Wonder if Saria is home. Well, you're not Saria. Have you been traveling around much, mister? Have you met a boy named Link? Mito said that the Great Deku Tree withered because that boy did something wrong to it. Only Saria defended Link. Until she left. Maybe we misunderstood. I legitimately didn't know that this dialogue was here. Now I'm curious. I want to go into the other houses to see if there's any other dialogue like that. I did not know about that. What about you? Haven't I seen you somewhere before, mister? Maybe. Maybe we met at that one convention. Maybe there's somebody in Mito's house. Ah! The Know-It-All Brothers. Why is that fairy following you around? You're not one of us!
One of us.
I see. You didn't have any problems entering the forest, mister. Did the meanies out there bother you much? Before the Great Deku Tree died, you wouldn't see things like that around here. Since it's dangerous outside, I always stay inside my house. But I'm bored to death in here! Dude, you have no idea. Let's see if there is any unique dialogue in here. Since the Great Deku Tree withered, more meanies have been appearing in the forest. I'm scared. An evil wind is blowing from the direction of the forest temple. Saria left, saying, I have to do something about it. The forest temple is located in the sacred forest meadow, at the far side of the Lost Woods. Where's Saria? Do you know Saria, mister? That's weird. Where has Mito gone during such an emergency? Yeah, where is he? He wasn't even in his house. Well, let's try Saria's song. You want to talk to Saria, right? Link? This is Saria. Can you hear me? Great! You're safe! I knew I would hear from you again. I'm in the forest temple. The forest spirits were calling me for help. So I went to check it out. But
It's full of evil monsters! Help me, Link! We couldn't save the Great Deku Tree, but we will save Saria. This, I swear! Okay, I turned it to nighttime because, you guessed it, there are gold skulltulas to be found here. What are you? Though you wear Kokiri-ish clothing, you can't fool me. I promise, Saria, I would never let anyone go through here. I promise, Saria, I would never let anyone go through here. I promised Saria, I would never let anybody go through here. Okay, I get ya. Maybe this will change your mind. That melody. Saria plays that song all the time. Do you know Saria? That song. Saria taught that song only to her friends. Okay, I trust you. When I see you, I don't know why, but I remember him. Who is him, mister? Who is him, huh? Who's him? When I see you, I don't know why, but I remember him. Oh crap, you're talking about him? Don't ever speak his name again. Pure evil. There's nothing quite like him. Anyway, coming up here, we get ourselves a gold skulltula. Very nice. And let's go through here and go up to the Sacred Forest Meadow. From here on, we'll be going through some narrow passages. If you take it slow, maybe you can sneak up on some enemies. Use L targeting to always look in the proper direction. Set your view so that you can see down the next corridor before you take a corner. Once your view is set, hold down L to sidestep around the corner. That way you won't be surprised by an enemy waiting for an ambush. So, you can see that there are enemies here, but there's also a little thing over there. And if we play... if we play the Scarecrow song, we can just latch up here and then just walk over the maze. This is fucking amazing. I love it. I figured this out on my most recent playthrough before this. And, it makes this section a joke. It's really funny. And we destroyed another gold skulltula. I think that's all the gold skulltulas in the Lost Woods, if I'm not mistaken. Yes, we have all of them. I think there's still one in the Kokiri Woods that we could get now, but, I'm not gonna. Ah! Ow. I love this section aesthetically. I love, like, this section aesthetically. Because, like, in the Zelda Collector's Edition, there's this cool little movie that plays whenever you play, like, the Zelda Collector's Edition thing. And this section always comes up. And it's just so freaking cool. Like, I'll play it here. So fucking cool looking. I love it. It's so cool. I just, man, I want to do something like this for when Breath of the Wild 2 comes out, because it's so fucking good. It's, maybe when Breath of the Wild 2, like, when I finish that game, I will do, like, a big, whole series animation. Definitely not coming for a while, I'll tell you that much, but it'll be so cool. Time is always cruel. Its speed seems different for each person, but no one can change it. A thing that doesn't change with time is a memory of younger days. In order to come back here again, play the minute of forest. You have learned the minute of forest. Link, I'll see you again. To answer you guys' next question, I don't know why that section was as bright as it was. I didn't do that. But I think that will do it for this episode. Next time on The Legend of Zelda, Ocarina of Time. we go into the forest temple and see if we can't rescue Saria. See you guys then.
Let it all out. Let it all out. You don't have to think your heart is made of steel. Come away now from your own doubt. Like a flower of hope that's growing in a field, you will heal. Although the road has changed you and the world has often failed you, you gotta carry on and show them you're strong. You gotta bury what is past and gone. Some days will be worse than others, but you gotta find another way. Chase the dawn that waits for us beyond the dark sky. Keep following the distant star. Never walk away from who you are. Never forget that your future's waiting up ahead. Seasons change and rearrange, and the sands of time descend. As all your hope starts vanishing, you'll always have a friend. Even by the snares of darkest night.